Ankle, just a little sprained ankle. It won't be anything. I'll be ready to go this weekend.
Was it the first catch?
Yeah, I just got kind of pulled down from behind, just rolled up on a little bit.
What's your thought process going into after that loss, going into Ohio State, going from one hard game to the very next one? How do you feel like the mood of the team is? And what's your...
Yeah, you know, the mood's good. It was a tough loss, but you know, we had him at some points, and we felt like we should have came out of that game with a win. Obviously, it didn't go that way, but you know, we're excited for this week. Another huge opportunity for us, and we kind of control our own destiny. So, guys are still pumped up; they're jacked to be able to go out to Columbus and play a great team in Ohio State. Could be a huge statement game for us. So we just gotta continue to keep preparing and just keep getting better. Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, obviously, too. You know, that being our first loss of the season has a lot to do with it compared to last season. But we felt like we played real hard, and just being able to go out there into a tough atmosphere at Madison and play as well as we did in some areas and almost come off the win, that says something about our team and how far we've come. So, you know, we're gonna take that into this week and just keep getting better. I hate losing. I hate losing. I'd rather win than have a moral victory.
Jordan, what do you remember about 2012 going to Ohio State? You run that trip, right?
I was not. I was hurt. Shocker. yeah, freshman year.
How do players view Ohio State? I mean, nationally, they're always portrayed as they won the national championship a couple years ago. Is this the kind of the bully of the Big Ten? Inside the locker room, you guys see that program?
Right. Yeah. I mean, they're kind of a different animal. You know, Ohio State, they've been so good for so long. So I mean, this is a huge game for us, and we know how good they are. But they're beatable, and you know, we're gonna watch film this week and see their tendencies, and you know, have real good film study and real good practices, and we'll be ready to go.
Ohio State seems like a team that could be intimidating, but when you see that the last three games they played them pretty close, does that kind of bring a different picture to it?
Yeah, you know, it makes you feel a little bit better that, you know, they are beatable, and you know, teams have been able to do stuff on them. So you know, we'll watch those games obviously real close and come up with an awesome game plan and be ready to go. It was a tough call to make from the ref standpoint, especially at a time like that. And it really doesn't matter what I think. I mean, it's said and done. It's a tough call. Obviously, I wish there was a flag thrown, but there wasn't, and you just got to move on.
Do you think you could have gotten to that ball where it was if you hadn't been impeded there? Do you think that it would have been catchable?
Yeah, I think so.
There's a perception by some that, you know, under the previous staff, you know, the team and the coaches would feel so much pressure for big time games, you know, top 10 matchups, and now you kind of just embrace the opportunity. Is that a fair assumption?
I really never felt that with the old staff. Obviously, different style of coaches, obviously. Coach Riley is obviously way more laid back, but I never really felt that. I mean, this year, going to this game, it's a big game for us, but we're not freaking out or anything like that. We'll take it like we do every single week. Every week's a Super Bowl for us, so it's just another great opportunity for us.
I know you haven't been part of all of these games, but the last three games, you guys have struggled with two-minute drills, both at the end of the first half and the end of the game. What do you think that might be tied to? Because in years past, you've been pretty good.
Yeah. Just poor execution. We just got to execute better, and you know, that's all of us. And we will. We'll get better. We'll keep practicing at that and just get better with it.
Was that a little bit of an emotional moment just before overtime, the coin flip, Foltz calling it, and Landon
Foltz? That was awesome. I think it's awesome that they do that coin for these games. And it was great to have his family there as well. It was a cool moment to have that flip and have it be Sam.
Do